2 days, $20,000, and away everything went. People just jumped in and helped where they could.
Last week, we brought you the story of members of one Northwestern Ontario Indigenous community who were being attacked on social media and even being denied access into businesses in Kenora. Fast forward a week later, numerous businesses in Kenora came together to support the members in the community who are fighting a COVID-19 outbreak. Owner of the Cornerstone, Pam Vinica, and owner of Sweet Lake of the Woods, Alexis Pernsky, created the Kenora Business Community Together Strong with Wabsamung Group to show support for Wabsamung Independent Nations. Around 60 Kenora businesses alongside community volunteers raised $20,000 for Wabsamung, including 352 care packages for youth in the community.
It just speaks louder than the other stuff, you know? The action and the amount of people that participated in minutes, you know, speaks louder than all the other garbage that's out there. So, you know, and it's just like, let's be positive. Let's stick together. Let's, you know, help each other.
It was nice to be able to do something for the youth and the community.
Alexis Pernsky says each child in the community got a gift card and the packages included things like games, snacks, and other supplies.
There were lots of things that went, you know, each child had something a little bit different, and it was nice to be able to put those together for everybody.
Wabsamung Independent Nations posted on their Facebook page thanking the business community for their support. Part of their statement reads, "The donation will be organized and brought to the community where it can then be distributed between the youth. Thank you to this group, Kenora Business Community Together Strong with Wabsamung, and to everyone else who has reached out and shown their support for our community at this time." Tanya Cameron, who City News spoke to last Saturday when the news broke, put out a statement saying, "This is absolutely uplifting news. To the business community in Kenora, well done. This is how to be a kind and caring neighbor." Pernsky says she is happy there was a ton of support from local businesses.
It was the right thing to do. There are a very close neighbor in community, and nobody was reluctant at all. It was a very easy decision to want to do something to support a community through a really difficult time.
You speak about the kindness part of it all, and you speak about the truth, then it kind of silenced the panic and the rudeness.
In Winnipeg, Alex Karpa, City News.